Well, Hoos, we are happy to be back in Scott Stadium today, especially to watch a game like the one that was played today. In typical UVA fashion, the Hoos left fans on the edge of their seats for the majority of the offensively powered game. But quarterback Michael Rocco launched a last-minute pass to Jake McGee in the end zone to win the game 41-40.
See the players and coaches just be really resilient. I'm so elated, so happy for those guys. Not, you know, whether it's putting me correct or not, I feel a tremendous blessing just occurred out there in that field. And it was just great to see, you know, guys, the locker room coming off the field with the students. Long time coming on victories like that. And we are, like I said, it's a great day for, you know, for the program. I know we are what the record is, but at the same time, we've been struggling like that. Take a victory against the Coastal leader. At that time, we played, I thought we played pretty good.
Even when we were losing games, you know, we knew that we had a good team, you know, that we got good players out there. And you know, once we all gel, you know, just go out there and do our assignments, you know, good things will happen for us.
Michael Rocco did get the start at quarterback today. The coaches began to implement the same quarterback rotation that we saw against NC State, and it did have some success. But it became clear very quickly that Michael Rocco was going to have his day today. He had a record-breaking performance in which he threw 18 consecutive passes and threw for 4 touchdowns.
Michael's done an outstanding job the last couple games, and you know, we talked about how selfless he is. He's a team player, and he wants to win. He has a great relationship with Phil. No one cares about who gets the credit. We just want to win football games. He does. He has a great understanding of the offense, and you know, and part of this time that we've traveled down this season, you'd have to ask him, but maybe it may have been a benefit to him as far as, you know, watching, but also competing, and you know. The thing that makes everyone better is when you have to compete. And like I said, I think that may be a record, I think, as far as 18 straight, Jim.
That's correct, right? Yes.
And very deserving, great teammate.
I'm a resilient guy. I feel like I'm a winner. I mean, you're not going to win every game. And as a quarterback, as a football player, you have to know that. But you got to prepare and act like you are going to win every game. And so I wasn't surprised whenever things were being said to me, like I wasn't going to play again and stuff like that. I mean, I had confidence. And really, I mean, I have a firm foundation. My family believes in me. My friends believe in me, and I believe in myself. And I mean, I just kind of prayed about it, stayed in the word, and kind of got confidence from that. And I just stuck with it. And I mean, here we are today on a 2-game win streak. It feels nice to be back on that. So.
Another notable thing to take away from today's game was the breakout performance of Dominique Terrell. He undoubtedly had the game of his career today with 9 catches for 127 yards. Miles Gooch also recorded his first touchdown today. Darius Jennings also grabbed 2. But one of the most spectacular things that we saw today was the last-minute touchdown by Jake McGee from quarterback Michael Rocco. As he's become known to do this season, he got up in the air, making those things that look impossible look easy.
I mean, if he threw it to me, I know I have to go get it. So I felt like it could have been even higher, and I would have been able to go get it. It's just one of those things. You have good timing with the quarterback, and it's just you have to come down with it.
Jake McGee is everything that, you know, we thought that he could be. I was asked the question, you know, when's the last time you seen a tight end that effective? And, of course, big money. You know, Heath Miller was here. And, you know, you can put Jake out in the slot formation, and defenses have to decide whether they want to put a linebacker out there on him. And obviously there's a mismatch because of his speed. And then they may put a safety on him. There's a bit of a mismatch because of his height. And so when you move him around and you do different things, you catch him in the blitz, you catch him in zone coverage or man-to-man coverage, sometimes you get the matchup that you want. And we got a couple of them today. And so, like I said, he's, you know, he puts bricks in his pockets to try to gain weight. He's going to have to, you know, gain some more weight here, but I think he'll be a good player for us.
Moving forward, coaches and players are well aware of the looming potential of a bowl game appearance if they win out for the rest of the season. London says it is the team's heart that will bring them to win both of those games and to appear in a bowl game this season. The Hoos are back in Scott Stadium this Thursday against UNC for a primetime game on ESPN. And after a showing like the one we saw today, the only thing left to say as we look forward to that game is Wahoo Wah. I'm Miranda Mason for Sabre TV.
I knew that these players don't quit. I mean, I knew that, you know, you go back and you look at just a play or two away, a third down conversion or whatever it may be, and you know, sometimes you can't measure desire, you can't measure heart, and it's tough when things don't go your way, and the players look to leadership to see, are we going to tank it, are we going to stay positive? And I'm an eternal optimist. I choose to be positive. And you know, if you can reflect that with the young men that you're in charge of or responsible for, and set the tone and the atmosphere of you can if we do this and do that, and accept nothing less, whether it's the classroom, whether it's in the community, or whether it's on the field, then I think that you set a culture that although things are happening on the negative side for us, that you know, you just believe that things can turn around and again, against a very good Miami team today, you know, we turned a corner.
The coaches, especially Coach Lennon, will never have and never will lose faith in us. So that's really when the guys on top are supporting you completely, you can't let them down.